Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous classes, we have learnt about triangles, types of triangles and their basic properties. In this video, we will throw some light on the congruence of triangles. So first, let's see what is congruence. Friends, do you think the biscuits in the same packet look big, small or different from each other? No. All biscuits are identical to each other. Similarly, you can see many examples in real life. For example, shoes of the same number, copies or notebooks, all 200 rupee notes and all 2000 rupee notes are identical to each other. And now, here are some objects that are not identical to each other. A 500 rupee note and a 2000 rupee note are not identical to each other. Shoes of different sizes and pens of two different companies, etc. Now we will study the concept of congruence in geometry. Congruence means equal in all respects, that is, those figures that have the same shape and size. To show any two figures as congruent, this symbol is used. Friends, do all circles look alike? All the circles appear to be round, but the only difference is that they can be bigger or smaller than each other. Can you tell when are two circles same or let's say congruent to each other? Circles drawn with the same radius are congruent to each other. That is, the congruency of a circle depends on the radius. Similarly, squares with equal sides are congruent to each other. For example, two or more squares with their sides measuring 4 cm are congruent to each other. Here, the congruency of a square depends on the side of a square. Let's now see the same in triangles. Three pairs of triangles are given on the screen. Look at them and tell which pair of triangles are congruent to each other. If you notice the first pair, the sides of the triangle are 3, 4 and 5 cm. The only difference is that the second triangle is rotated. If the corresponding sides of the triangle are equal, then the triangles will be congruent. What do you think looking at the second pair? Yes, these are also congruent triangles. These look like a mirror image of each other. Now notice the last pair. These triangles are not congruent to each other because the sides of these two triangles are not equal to each other. Friends, we can see the congruent pair of triangles by keeping the corresponding equal sides on top of each other. The vertex, sides and angles of the triangles are fitting exactly on each other, and the triangles that are not congruent are not covering each other completely. Let's move on. Here, it is given that triangle XYZ is congruent to triangle LMN. Here, side XY covers side LM, side YZ covers side MN, and side ZX covers side NL. And we represent it this way. Angle X covers angle L, angle Y covers angle M, and angle Z covers angle N. We write it this way. Can we say the same for the vertex as well? Yes. Vertex X corresponds to vertex L, vertex Y corresponds to vertex M, and vertex Z corresponds to vertex N. Friends, from this we can conclude that the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal to each other. We abbreviate it as CPCT, that is, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Note an important point here, that triangle XYZ is congruent to triangle LMN. But if we write this as triangle XYZ is congruent to triangle MNL, then it would be wrong because there is a one-to-one correspondence between both the triangles. So friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed the congruence of triangles. See you in the next video. Thank you.